Wembley, great Wembley. Not long ago, the focal point for world soccer, now the setting for the greatest prize of English football, the FA Cup. This year, a Cockney Cup Final. Chelsea versus Tottenham Hotspur, two brilliant London teams. Outside, those without a hope of getting in. Inside, 100,000 let out the Wembley roar. Spurs went straight into the attack. Chelsea quickly replied. Charlie Cook surged down the right wing. Into the middle, but the safe hands of Jennings collected easily. Now it was the turn of Tottenham wonderboy Greaves. Gilzean was with him. It spelt danger for Chelsea. No luck for Saul that time. McCrudy for Chelsea. His upfield clearance found Hollins. A great try, and what a save. From the corner, it was Jennings who again took Spurs out of danger. Both teams are playing steady football, often with flashes of brilliance. Far better than many critics had predicted. Notable for Chelsea was Cook. He rattled Jennings with that one. But Spurs had the edge. Mullery's shot hit a defender. Robertson was perfect for the rebound. Minutes gone, Spurs one goal ahead. Bad for Chelsea. The interval robbed them of the chance to strike back while the iron was hot. And Chelsea felt it. But it was only one goal, and both teams looked serious as they went off at half-time. Let's relive that first half through some of the faces in the crowd. The faces of Wembley. The second half began. Robertson's goal had its effect on both teams. Spurs bent on increasing their lead, Chelsea on drawing level and going ahead themselves. Chelsea had a more determined look about them now than just before the interval. The centre from the right, and Hatley's header went just over. The least experienced man in the Tottenham side, young Joe Kinnear, played like a man inspired. His shot here deflected for a corner. Greaves took the kick, only for Chelsea to turn danger into attack. Eddie McCready's header gave Jennings little trouble. Again, and decisively as it turned out, the sheer class of Tottenham Hotspur showed itself. From Robertson's header, Frank Saul shot into the net. Might have been another for Spurs, but Greaves' shot was brilliantly saved. On came Chelsea now. Baldwin to Hatley, but still no luck. A few minutes before the end, Chelsea got a goal. Boyle centred. Tambling headed in. But the Chelsea time had run out. They failed to get the equaliser. Spurs 2, Chelsea 1 at the final whistle. Great players and great sportsmen, London's old rivals had given the 100,000 at Wembley a final to be long remembered. Cup winners' medals were waiting up there for Tottenham Hotspur. And once again, the last hurdle had proved too much for Chelsea. To a very proud Dave Mackay, the Duke of Kent presented the trophy, which in the whole field of sport is surely the most coveted, the FA Cup. Mackay was in Spurs' cup-winning team in 61, again in 62, and here he was for the third time, and that despite a twice-broken leg. The fans have good reason to call him the Iron Man. Mike England, the man Tony Hatley couldn't master. Jimmy Greaves and Alan Gilzean, a great combination. Chelsea's year is bound to come before long. Jimmy Greaves, left out of the World Cup, now back on top of the world. Joe Kinnear and Jim Robertson. Alan Mullery, always an original, one for the pot. Finally, inspiration of the side, Dave Mackay, captain of cup-winning Tottenham Hotspur.